Hello guys, look who's here.
Wolf.
Let me get him.
Wolf. Wolf.
Give me a moment. Now everything's better.
Wolf.
He has grown. He's very big. Look at the hair on his back. Starting changing.
Wolf. Wolf.
He's a big boy now. And he bites. So, I'm going to play with him a moment, and then I'll get back to you with Buddy. And here we have Buddy. Buddy! Okay. Again, he's over me. Now we're enjoying this, as you can see. The value here is his leg. Come on, buddy. Tap dancing. Okay. A big one. So, let's see what I have done here and what we're going to do. In the last video, I placed the stem and underneath the keel up to the end. Over here, I had to cut it a little bit so it would be a match. And also, I had to form this piece according to the gap that I have over here. Here I have placed some wood putty, so what I'm going to do now is trim it a little bit so I can fit this piece, and also I'm going to find a piece to glue underneath here, sand it down and make it look perfect. Let me do that because this is not something hard, just fitting and sanding, and I'll get back to you because we have to put here the copper parts for the current to be able to apply the current from the base. Also, I'm going to glue this, not hard. And I'll get back to you because we have some work to do on the stern. Let me do that. All right, now this is a piece 1x5. I have glued it. As you see, it finishes perfectly and cover up the nails and the ugliness. The front part will be stained. Okay, nothing I can do to hide that except some stain. Now we have here some copper. Let me cut a piece. Let me make this straight. Let me get that. I hate it when things are dropping on the floor, and I hate them even worse when I cannot find them. Let me glue that. Bless me. So, one is ready. Unglued from the other side, but okay, I can fix that. Thank you. Let me glue it. All right. Got them, both of them. Later I'm going to do a test run to see if everything is all right. Hopefully everything is all right. And now we have the next step to do. This piece back here is glued. The glue is not dry yet. I believe the rear part is very good. As you can see here, I have cut off the edges, and I'll get right to the point. The next thing we need to do is place the stem. The stem is this one. Of course, you can realize that there are no windows here, so I have to open them. As you have already seen, I have marked exactly where the windows are going, exactly. So I have to cut open these holes. This is the piece that is going to be after we mount the wooden piece. Also, this one needs painting. It's not, I don't need it at the moment, just for the drawing for the windows. Let's see now what we have to do. I'm not sure exactly how this is going, but I'm guessing. Here we have this piece that is extended a little bit, so here we have to insert this. To be able to insert this, I have to do it approximately here. Approximately here, these pieces are in the way. So, as you can see, I have marked them and I'm going to cut them. So, this hopefully will be exactly where I need it. Also, I have these pieces exceeded and this piece exceeded. Probably I will need to cut them down, but I'm not going to do anything until I fit the lower part of the stern. But first of all, I have to open up the windows. And let me figure out how to do that. I believe the most precise way is this. I must be very, very careful. Let me open them all. Let me trim the interior to make it sanded, to make it correct, and I'll get back to you. All right, I have it. Also, this part, as you can see here, I have a fit. Of course, need some pressure here to be able to glue it. It's not a problem. What is a problem, but I'm going to solve it easily, is that, as you can see, the upper half of the windows are looking over the deck. That's not a problem because I have anticipated something that I would have done to hide these wires, and that was to plank the interior with these wood strips. So everything is going to be planked on the interior, so I will be able to hide the wires. So not a problem. Now let's glue it. Of course, here I need to use white glue. And definitely some pins. Let me change the view. All right. Have to secure it somehow. All right. Beautiful. Now I have to wait for the glue to dry, of course. Here probably we're going to need some sanding, but that's okay. I will have lights only here on the lower part, but from nothing it's far better. Okay, let's see now if I can work a little bit with cyanoacrylic glue over here to plank the area. We're going to do some planking like that. Let's see if I can glue a couple, and if I can, I'll get back to you to do it. Now, as you can see, I started doing the planking carefully, very, very carefully, only with cyanoacrylic glue, without much pressure, because the piece is not, the piece of the stand is not glued yet. I'm going to leave open for now. I'm not going to glue anything here in the middle, because there's going to be some work here. I need to open up a small channel over here, so I can have the wires coming over here and up here and through a hole that's going to be opened right about there. So let me do the entire surface except the middle, and I'll get back to you to show you the finished result. All right, let me show you a couple of things, because it took me around an hour to do. Οπότε, so, as you can see here, the wires were coming out from here, and now they're coming out under the deck. So, no visible wires. Everything is planked over here. Probably we need to do some planking over here as well, and I believe some here is in order. Anyhow, I will plank this after I put the pieces here, because some pieces are going over here. So in that time I will do some planking, not earlier. Probably I need to do some planking over here, perhaps because of the rails. I will see. Nothing hard. Maybe I'll cut this piece and put the rails, then put another piece above. Everything is fixable, so don't worry about that. Now, you can see here that I have left a gap. This gap has left on purpose, because somewhere around here there's going to be a hole that we're going to pass the wires for the ladder, and also the ladder will be attached over here. So these wires are going up this way and coming out from a hole that is going to be somewhere around here. This is the piece that is going to be over here. It's calculated, it fits exactly, so it's perfect. And as you see on the inside, I have carved it so I can pass the wires, and this is going to be on the inside. So we are ready for the next step. That's going to be the rails, but the glue is not dry yet over the stern, so this will be done on our next video. So guys, thank you very much for watching. As you can see, mistakes can be done during the build, but wood forgives almost everything, almost. The wires have gone underneath. There is not going to be any visible wires. That's what I am happy about. But we didn't do a test run, so give me a moment to have the stand base over here, and I'll get back to you to show you the test run. Here we are with Buddy. He's again all over me. Buddy, get off me. Get off me, Buddy. So like I said before, we're going to have only from the lower part of the stern, but okay, I can live with that. Here's the side, here's the bow, the hatches, and of course I moved it, and of course underneath the upper deck. And so the stand base not secured, the stand base is not fit for this model. You can see we have gaps. This is fixable, but not at the moment. So guys, with me, from me and buddy, who is expecting a pet, you can see that. We thank you very much for watching. Don't forget the super thanks ability, and I hope to see you in our next video, that we're going to do some more work and make the Calderadia even more beautiful. Take care, everybody.